This is Dr. Greg Gillum, CEO of Human Fusion. In this video, we're going to be talking about one of the 24 traits of the Winslow Dynamics profile. This trait is known as conscientiousness. It is still in the top three in the intrapersonal category, therefore it's still a dominant trait. Now let's look at what it actually means. So if you score high in conscientiousness as a manager, you place the welfare of others before your own personal preferences and priorities. You're willing to follow rules and regulations. In fact, that is your primary driver, is rules and regulations, policies, procedures. You love to dot I's and cross T's. You tend to be exacting in character, so you're very maybe prone to perfectionism because you're so exacting in the way you act, and you're dominated by a sense of duty. One of the defining behaviors that we look at when a company is really concerned about loyalty, we look at conscientiousness and we look at coachability, which we'll go over later. But those are the two that really define loyalty to companies. And finally, people who have high conscientiousness will not try to take advantage of other people. So when we look at the spectrum of traits here, if you score very high, so if you score an 8 or a 8, 9 or 10 on the Winslow profile, which is a scale from 1 to 10, your priorities are based firstly on external expectations and rules. It's other focused. So everything typically kind of comes from the outside when you have a very high conscientiousness score. The potential pitfall there is that you can ignore your own needs and you can then get boxed in by your own rules and your own sort of tendency to follow the rules at all costs. And it can really limit sort of out of the box type of thinking. So innovation, innovative thinking, you know, that kind of thing can really be limited by very high conscientiousness. Now, on the lower end, so if you score influentially low, 1 to 3 on the scale, your actions are based primarily on internal priorities. You become very self-centered. Now, I've gotten into lots of quasi-arguments over this trait over the years because some of the language around this at the low end talks about selfishness. It's not, people interpret it as selfishness. What it's saying is it's you're self-centered. You think of yourself first, and you can be oblivious to other people's needs. And so you have to be very careful, you know, at the high end of conscientiousness as a manager, because you can just give, and really kind of burn yourself out. But you have to be very careful, probably more careful on the other end of conscientiousness if you score low there, because you're, as a self-centered person, you're going to think about yourself before you think about your direct reports. And that can lead into some very dangerous waters in terms of building trust and rapport. No matter what your score is on conscientiousness, you need to know what it is, and Human Fusion can help. If you like management-related videos like this, please subscribe to Human Fusion, and we'll keep you up to date on all the latest trends that are affecting you as a manager and your management practice.